Welcome to the last session of this week of the Visual J Forex Automated Trading with Visual J Forex Day 5. And today I will show you what are the trading blocks available in the Visual J Forex. Then we will build a simple strategy with some simple logics related to EMA moving averages. So close and cancel is there. Suppose if you want to close and cancel the position as soon as the condition changes, then you can use this block. Custom trailing stop, here you can revise your stop loss by following a method of trailing stop loss, and in this block you can use the stop loss, trailing stop loss by less than 10 pips, and the trailing stop loss you will need to default stop loss of 10 pips, default trailing stop loss of 10 pips. So that is the difference between trailing stop loss and custom trailing stop loss block. And then we have got the pending open. Suppose if you want to open a trade at particular price by using the calculation block, then you can use this pending open block. And then set take profit, and similarly as you use a set stop loss, similarly you can revise your take profit levels. If the conditions gets more favorable, then you can increase order. If conditions gets less favorable, that time you can decrease the take profit level. If condition gets more favorable, that time you can increase the take profit level. So but for this you will need to provide the additional logic of those conditions which are in your mind. So these are the trading blocks available in the Visual J Forex. Now let us start developing a very simple strategy for this week. And next week, friend, whole week is devoting to developing strategies using the E block. And the next week will be the first week where we will actually start developing strategy. So first I will start with some easy concept so that it will be easy for you to learn and practice. Now I will show you logic on the JForex platform. So I want to keep logic that this is the Euro USD instrument 4-hourly chart, and as soon as the candle closes above the 4-hourly chart, it will open up long trade. And as soon as candle closes below the 4-hourly chart, that time it will open a short trade. So logic is very simple. If it closes above the 200 SMA, then strategy will open a buy trade. And if candle closes below the 200 SMA, that time it will open a short trade. So let's begin. Now for that, as I want at one time my strategy should open a one trade. For that I will need to use a E block. Now as just I have shown you, our logic is based on the candles values, then that's why I am using a start point as a candle on candle. Connect the start point with the block starting point. Then now we will need a position amount. So as I want to check whether there is any trade open on my trading account, so that's why we will need a variable from the position info section, and there you will need to use open position, position amount. So what I did, I will show you again. Click on the position info, then all position, open position, position amount, pending positions. So as we want to check whether there are any open positions, that's why I am using open positions, position amount variable. Now click on the open position and then select the variable position amount and then drag here. One more time I will show you, and then drag here. So this is the position, open position, position amount I want 0. Then only my strategy will open a trade when there are no open positions on my trading account. Next, I want to define the candle period, because I am using my logic on 4 hourly candle. So that's why I will define the candle period and when I will define the candle period, that time strategy will check as soon as the 4 hour candle closes. Then only it will check the whether there are any conditions fulfilled as per the logic, and then only it will open a trade. That's why it's always good to define a candle period on which your strategy is based. So now on your left side, click on candle option, and then you can use the last ask candle or the last bid candle. Let me check. So as this candlestick pattern is a bid, here you can change bid or ask, as this is my logic is on bid. So I will use the last bid candle. Then click on last bid candle and then click the candle period variable and then drag it to the if block. As soon as use the variable candle period, if block got adjusted to 2 output only, because we know candle period will be equal to the prescribed value or it will not equal to. So only 2 possible scenario, that's why if block got adjusted automatically. Now select the period. As I am using the 4 hourly, you can use any period as per your logic. Now block has turned to green. If you have noticed, initially it was in red color. Now I want to define an instrument so that I need one more block. Notice here, initially a block is always in red because it's not a ready to use directly. We need to first fill all the both the inputs, that is the first input and second input, then only it gets ready to open to use in the strategy. Now I will connect first input equal to the second input, that is the equal to sign, with the starting point of the next if block. Here also I did the same thing. I have connected equal to option with the start point of the next if block. Now candle instrument, I will put this variable in the first block. Again here, as now candle instrument will be the only when we will use the candle instrument variable if block got adjusted to 2 outputs, because either it will be equal to the second output or it will not be equal to, only 2 possible scenarios. That time if block gets adjusted to 2 outputs only. So I have filled both the inputs. One more time I will show you. Now let me remove this. Click on the start button and then you will see the option. From there you can choose any instrument you want. As I want Euro USD, I will select that. Then now block is status bar is green, ready to use. Now I need a SMA block, as my strategy's logic is based on the SMS. So click on the indicator option on your right side. There you will find the MA option, moving averages indicator option. and from there you will another column will get open up. From there select the SMA block. So as all the variables are filled initially, that's why status bar is green. Now connect the equal to open as we want to. Last bit candle, candle instrument should be Euro USD. So you should connect equal to option with the start point of the next indicator. So SMA. Now default instrument Euro USD, it is a already placed value, but still I will change it. Now remove this variable and then click on the star sign. So here you can select the variable. I want the Euro USD, so I will select the instrument Euro USD. Now period I want 4 hourly, that's why I will change the period. Again click on the star and then you can select the any period you want, as my strategy's logic is based on the 4 hourly and that's why I am using the 4 hours. Then shift is used to shift the candle values by as much amount as you want. Suppose you want the last closed candle or before prior to that candles, so that way you can like one shift one means it will consider the previous candle than the current one. If you will use the two, that means it will consider the candle value before the two candles. So this way you can use the shift integer. As I want the current candle, as soon as current candle closes above the SMA 200, that time I want strategy should open a buy trade, and vice versa, as soon as the current candle closes below the SMA 200, I want strategy should execute a sell trade. That's why I am not changing the shift value. Now time period. We need a 200 time period here, so we will change it. Remove this variable or you can change it that. Click on the star button and then put the value here. So I want the 200 period, so I am putting 200 value. Now this is the time period. Now I want to rename this variable as it should be more relevant to understand, more relevant to block. So line 22 I will not understand when I will come back and check the strategy. That's why I don't want any confusion. So it's always better to keep the variable's name as per the block's values. So as we are using the SMA 200, so I will rename it SMA 200. For that, what you need to do, click on the line double option and then variables, edit variable dialog box will pop up. Here change the name. I will keep it SMA 200. Now start value, it's always good to use a 0 so that strategy will begin with the value of 0 and it will check for that desired levels. Now next we have got the global option, false true. So true means it will be visible by when you will go for the strategy testing, that time you can check the value. False means it will not visible that time. So it depends on you whether you want to put it true or false. I will show you how it works practically next time. And then click on the save. So as I have created my own variable, it will be available in the users variable section. You can check here. On your left side, click on the user variables, and there you will get the SMA 200 as I have created it. Okay. Now we will use the simple block, a simple if block. So click on most used, and then in this line you will get the if block. Now connect the indicators call option with the starting point of the if block. So what I want, candle close. Now again you will need to go back to the last bit candle option. From there select the option candle close and bring that variable to the if block. As we are dealing with the candle close values, as soon as candle closes above the SMA 200, then it should open a buy. As soon as candle closes below SMA 200, it should open a sell. So that's where we want the candle, last bit candle, candle close. As here we have used the last bit candle, candle period, last bit candle, candle instrument. So whenever you are using any variable, keep it same all over in all the blocks and in the whole logic. Otherwise the strategy will not function properly and it will malfunction, and in the end it will be failure. So that's why better use, always take care of this. Whatever you are using, use it in synchronous with another variables or with your logic. Now last bit candle close, we need a this variable here SMA 200, because we want, if candle closes above that we want buy trend, if candle closes below this SMA 200 value we want a sell trend. Now we will need a open at market blocks, and we need a two blocks, for one for buy, one for sell. Now I will hide the panel as my work finished here. This helps to create more space on the workspace area. So I can minimize both the panels as well. Now if candle close is above the 200, SMA 200, first input greater than second input, that time strategy should open a buy trade. And when candle close is below SMA 200, that time it should open a sell trade. So connect the greater than option with the one open at market block. Now let us change the default variable here. Command, we need a buy, and then here we need a sell. So now connect the first input less than second input option with the start point of sell command open at market block. Now default instrument EURUSD, it's a correct one. Still I am removing it and I am adding as my way I did earlier. You can keep as it is because the instrument is same. So change the instrument in both the blocks. And then trade amount. You will need to fill the required trade amount, the amount you which you want lot size. So 0.001, it's a micro lot, means it will open for 1000, and for 10,000 you will need to open 0.010. 0.1 means 1 lakh, and 1 means 1 million. So as we are just testing this strategy on the demo account, let us keep it as it is 0.001. it will open the trade with the micro lot, that is for 1000. Default slippage, you can change this value as per your wishes. So let us go for lesser numbers. I'm keeping it 0.3. Means slippage means what happens if you trade the manually, that time when you place the order, that time also this option is already there on the JForex platform. So while filling the order, slippage, how much slippage you can allow, like you want the trade value at around 1 point, and then slippage will be of 0.003 pips. So like that, it will depend on the instrument as well. So how much slippage you want to allow, you can change that. Here I will keep it same 3. So this is the distance between how much you want to allow between the your trade price and between the market price that time. And then default stop loss is 25 pips. I want to change it to 50 pips. As my strategy is based on the 4-hourly chart, this is just the today I am showing you a simple example of simple strategy. When we will go for advanced strategy developing program, that time we can use the help of several other indicators, like ATR is there or pending open option is there. So that time, as we are just about to begin our strategy developing skills, so that's why better start with some simple concept. Now 50 to 100, stop loss will be of 50 pips and take profit is of 100 pips. So our strategy is ready. Now our blocks are connected with each other. So start point is on candle, we will check it. So when I click on the on candle start point option, that time color, it shows us if sometimes now it's a very easy strategy, we have a few blocks in our strategy, so it's easy to check manually. But sometimes while making an advanced strategy, we may forget to connect the blocks with each other. That time by clicking on this color start point on candle start point option, we can, when the color changes, that it shows all blocks are connected with each other. Sometimes like I will show you, when the any link is broken, the color will not change. Color will also show a interruption, that half is the half linking line color is the purple, and from after the breaking point the color is white. So it's easy for you to find the to check the if there is any miscommunication with the blocks, or if you forget to connect the blocks. That time when we have so many blocks in our strategy, it's always better to use this option. So when the color is Purple threw out the blocks. Throughout the strategy, it suggests strategy is all blocks are connected in the strategy. Now we will test run it. And if you have watched my previous videos on how to test run the strategy, you will be aware with that how to test run the strategy in the J4X platform. I will show you today on my here also we can run the strategy, but if in the J4X platform strategy gets we can check the strategy's running period with more speed. That's why I always use J4X. And another problem is that here you will need to manually log in into the demo account, while in the J4X platform you can use this function directly by just importing the strategy in J4X. Now what I will do, I will click on the compiler option and then I will click on the build option. If you remember why to use this build option converts the strategy code into Java backend. So it will be easy for us to use this strategy in the J4X platform. Now I will click on build option and I will save it SMA 200. Always give a relevant name to your strategy so it will be easy for you to remember. SMA 200 save. Now we have got the dialog box, strategy was built successfully. So message, we have got means we have finished the building strategy. Now next click on the view source option. Here you can check the Java code. Now I told you what to do next. Check one more time. Click on the strategy option on the repository panel. And then click on the My Strategies option. As soon as we create a Java backend code, that time our strategy gets stored in the My Strategy section. And this section is linked to your J4X platform. And the J4X platform means the account which you have linked with the community. Suppose you are a community member and you are using a prize accounts, then it is automatically linked to that account. If not, I always suggest use a demo account, as I have tested so many strategies with this, so I can take a risk, but any newcomer or any beginner should not take that risk. Always use a demo account to test run the strategy. And that also I have shown you in previous webinar or day yesterday or a day before yesterday. So watch that video and then only test run. Then from there you will get to know how to test run the strategy in the J4X platform. Now I am going to J4X platform. Here click on the eye icon and then navigator panel will get pops up. Now SMA 200. We have just developed the strategy here. Now it is and then function as I have added, it was visible here. So now click on the strategies, expand it, and then Visual J4X. One more time, custom, minimize it, and then expand it. Oh no, why our strategy is not visible here? I will need to refresh it. Let me click on the save option one more time. As it is visible here, so it should be visible there as well. So I believe I will need to log out one more time, and then I will need to log in again. Yes. So let me log out, and then I will log in again. You can try yourself. Now you can log in into your demo account when you will watch the video that time. This is, I am logging into my JForex account. And with this, I have also shown you another option. You can export the strategy. When you will go for strategy testing in demo account, you will need to do that. So now, oh, something missing here as it is not available. I believe only 5 strategies are. Let me remove one of them. Something is not correct, and it is JForex failed to import that strategy. So what we will do, we will manually open the strategy. Now click on the view option and then click on the strategies. So here what I will do, I will export the strategy in the Java format. And same strategy I will import in the, so it's better you can use the same system in the demo. And then I will open it. Click on the open option. Sum it 200. So all these strategies I have built and tested for the contest. So where is SM 200? Let me find out. I will check one more time in the SMA 200. I will check the path. Oh, this PC videos, it has got saved in there and here. I will need to check this PC videos. SMA 200. So now it is open. Now right click on it. Compile it first. First step, you will need to click on the compile option. After that, click check the messages tab, compiling SMA 200 and the compilation successful. If there is any error that day I have shown you, it will show that error line, and those are the Java specialists, those know the programming in Java, they can correct that manually. Or as I'm not the Java specialist, what I will do, I will go back to my Visual J4X. I will make correction there, and from there again I will come back. Now come back to strategy SMA 200, right click again and then click on the test option. Here you can change the account value. 50,000 enough, and then I'll click on the visual mode and then I will go for a previous week, or you can go for a previous month as well, and then process all ticks. Nothing, no need to change all these things. You just need to click on the visual mode and then account and then instrument, already Euro USD, so I am fine with that. Now click on the start. Yes, 10 minutes slot is at same default stop loss 50 pips, and then take profit 100 pips, default slippage is 3, and then run. Now let us see how our strategy performs. I will open it in another box window, so it will be easy for you to watch. It takes some time. Now started. As it is, this is the hourly. We can change this time to 4 hours to get the exact idea. Okay. So come to know. Let me check whether open positions, pending orders, historical. Now click on all these options, so you will come to know when your strategy will open a trade. So first trade is open. This is now click check here. Strategy has opened a sale trade, and here it is the stop loss levels, and when, and this is the take profit level. Now let us see what happens to our first trade, whether it gets close in the with a profit or in loss. So that's why click on the chart layers option as well. Tick all the boxes, pending orders, open position, historical orders position, and order preview. So by this way, you will get the idea that when your strategy is opening a trade and when it is closing. One trade it has opened. Main strategy we have built it successfully. And if it gets closes in profit, then it will be logic is fine. But this is just a simple example. This way you can. Now next time we will, next week we will develop different types of strategies with different indicators. As soon as this test run finishes, we will, yes, our order got filled here. Now as soon as it has filled and candles is still below the SMA 200, it has opened another trade. Here all got filled. Now let us see. $1.117, it is showing us a value, and then it has filled at the levels. These details we will get when strategy shows a whole data after it finishes the test run for the specific period. Now let us check in the Chrome. So this way you will get the result. So initial deposit was the 50,000. Our strategy, we have kept the lot size of just 1,000, and that's why we have got the profit of 12 cents. Now see, positions total it has opened 2, one position closed and second position is open, and the profit showing is at the end is 8.8. So this is the example of how you will need to develop a strategy. So that's it for the day, friends. And one more thing I want to tell you before that, you will get all the details here. At what value strategy opened a trade, order submitted, time, and then order filled, as we have used the market open block. If pending open, that time it will look for that specific value. So I will show you all these things in coming days. So that's it for the day, friends. Try all this on your own. If you face any difficulties, ask me in the comment box. I will be happy to answer that in my next webinar. So I wish all my friends a very profitable trading.